requires a reservation or a pretty long line. We're at the Venetian trying to check in. It's more like a Disneyland ride.
It's pretty in here, inside the Venetian. It's like the main mall.
Outdoor gondola. People in line waiting to go. Treasure Island, the Venetian, that's where we are. Kind of a pretty pond and statue. Louis Vuitton is the place to be today. We're in the Bellagio Mall. Balloons inside the Bellagio. Kind of pretty. Fancy smancy. Harry Winston diamonds. Closed, just like everything else. Really pretty in here. Inside the Bellagio. Las Vegas Boulevard. Hopping on Valentine's. 2021. Here's the other side. Lots of people out today. Got into our room at the Venetian this time, and it is a very nice room. Even if Vegas kind of sucks, this room's fabulous. Happy Valentine's, cowboy.
Thank you.
Waiting at the Venetian for the valet to bring us our truck. That was a little weird, just handing over the keys to the truck. It's the MGM Grand, and that is huge. That's several stories high. Across the street, we have New York, New York. Lady Liberty has a mask on. Here we are in the M&M store. How cool is that? Look at all those colors.
Sorry.
The Reese's store. Statue of Liberty. It's kind of cool at the New York, New York. Parking. It's kind of nice.
There's no one at home. It's quite beautiful here in Las Vegas.
Water's in here.
Yeah. So we're just going to park. They're going to give us a ticket and they'll take our truck and park it and bring it back when we're ready to go. Pretty nice. So they give you a ticket, they'll go park it for you, and we just go in. It's pretty nice.
What is that? How are you?
Been married for 30 years.
And how many you say?
30.
30 years, right? I think they had the most mass back on there for me. And they're already yelling it to me in my radio. It's Big Brother's watching everywhere. Well, thank you so much for joining us. And thank you for joining us, actually, on the Gongo Land as well. We have been traveling down from Branson, Alabama. Now, this is like the neighborhood of the city. I like to call it Danny, the neighborhood. And it is here that we're going to be. Now, the four is the most beautiful.
Sure, this is the right road, but Google has us on a gravel road for 29 miles to Oatman. Pray for us. Well, Google says we're only about 3 miles from Oatman. This has been an interesting route. Oh, here we come. Pavement.
Something more.
Turn right onto Oatman Highway, Oatman Topic Highway.
I'm really glad we drove the truck. Made this road. Looks like we made it to Oatman. We're gonna park and walk down the street. Yay, we made it to Oatman. To park, you put $2 in the whiskey barrel. Post office. A cute little trailer. Love it. Let's go here. Kangaroo, alligator, wild boar, fudge. Famous Oatman, Arizona. Get you a sack here.
Jackass Junction.
Hotel 1902. Do you want another? Don't bite me. Okay, come here. I'll give you one. All right, let's go find another one. Look at this lonely guy in the road. We'll go see if he wants some. Oh, look, I have friends. Oh, you're gonna try to cut me off. This guy is not, he's not interested in sharing. Okay, here's one more. Oh yeah, come here, little fella. You can have one. Come on, bud. We have little blocks of alfalfa. Old cabin. Look at that cactus growing through the roof. Another part of the roof. I think these guys are exempt from building codes here. But I do love the cactus. Not too bothered by traffic.
Let you take a picture of these so that you know which ones that you might
Fast Fanny's. Still on the hunt for some earrings. Plenty of options in here. Some books about Olive Oatman. We read that once. It's a very interesting story. Highly recommended. And that's what this cute little town's named after. Adorable place, the Olive Oatman restaurant. This is totally our style. We got ice and a can. We like this little town. Well, we weren't super hungry, so Jason just went with a hot dog and fries. I'm going with a salad. It looks pretty good. Burrows on the road.
coming up into the town of Oatman. We're leaving.
It's not every day you see a burro on the road.
Hey, fella. What do you want? Do you want something to eat? Okay, hold on. Let me find you something.
All right. We've got a banana. Let's see. Oh, yeah.
You like
bananas are good.
You like bananas?
Yeah, that's good stuff right there.
Yeah, they're pretty good. A wonky donk. A wonky donkey.
We're headed down Route 66. We just left Kingman. We're headed towards Tucson, Arizona. We're headed towards Wickenburg. These cute spurs in the middle of the road. Cruising through Phoenix. It's amazing. All this farmland down here. It's winter, but it's very green and they're growing, so it must be the growing season for southern Arizona. Well, we're about 40 miles from Tucson. We're gonna stay here for the night, and then tomorrow we are gonna head to Tombstone.
Beautiful sunset tonight on our way into Tucson.
Well, we're on the road again. We're out a little early this morning. We're heading out of Tucson towards Tombstone. We'll get there early, have some breakfast, and then who knows where. Beautiful Arizona sunrise. Here we are. Boot Hill Cemetery in Tombstone. So it's really early. We decided to go through Tombstone quickly and just head on down to Bisbee, which they say is the most beautiful city in Arizona. Then we'll turn around and go back to Tombstone. So far, driving into Bisbee is pretty. I wasn't expecting hills after that flatland we just traveled through. Here we are in Bisbee. How adorable is this? Bisbee. Pretty early in the morning still, 8 a.m. Trying to find somewhere to eat. The Bisbee Grand Hotel says it has booze, beds, food, and fun. So we're gonna go see if we can find the latter, food and fun. Wow, check this place out. Awesome. We're in the saloon in Bisbee. Here we are in Bisbee at the Grand Hotel Saloon, getting a little breakfast. Jason's going with the usual pancakes, bacon, orange juice. I got my bacon and egg and Diet Coke. It's a good life. Could be in a movie set in here. It's quite awesome. It's cute houses. Ooh, there's a big church. Looks like there's probably just kind of one main road, and then all the houses and stuff are up along the hills. All right, we made it back to Tombstone. Here we are at Tombstone.
This is the Birdcage Theater.
Gorgeous to be in. It was a saloon gambling hall, house of negotiable affections.
Now we're in the Birdcage in the back, looking at all the cool antiques. Some of the bullets and equipment from the doctor who used to come to the rescue after gunfights. Chamber pots before indoor plumbing. Here we are in the Birdhouse Theater. You can see the birdhouses up on each side, which kind of also doubled as a house of ill repute in each of those rooms. Poker room. I think this might have been a hotel room. A
We're walking down Tombstone's main road. We got the Crystal Palace here. We got a stagecoach in front of us. Let's see if we can go for a ride on that.
11-1-3.
That's a lot.
Yeah.
I don't know, that's not worth the felony.
Yeah, see? It's not worth the felony, no, it's not.
All right, we're in the stagecoach.
Taylor and Ackman's, because that's going to be where it really happened on October 26th of 1881. Tell about the house we are, but first off, it's okay.
It's called the Bensby Massacre, and John sentenced to life in prison until February 22nd, 1884.
We're about to watch the gunfight at the OK Corral.
Looking for a fight? Now I can help them.
Drop your hands. I want your guns. Oh, it's not what I want!
Road trip staples. Diet Coke for me, Hot Cheetos for Jason, and Cody Jinx on the radio for both of us. Isn't he awesome? Well, that's a wrap for Tombstone. We're on the road, and possibly Sedona, possibly Santa Fe. I don't know. We'll see when we get there. Cruising through Phoenix right now. We're headed to Sedona. 2 hours to Sedona. Well, we're out of the city now, out of Phoenix. We're on Highway 17 or I-17, headed north to Sedona. And look at all these awesome, humongous cactuses. A little closer. We're probably about 40 miles from Sedona. The hills are kind of cool. I think that's Sedona out there. See the red cliffs. It's like they're. Well, we made it to Sedona. Village Lodge in Oak Creek, which is just like 5 miles from Sedona. And this is a great place. And the guy who helped us at the front was awesome. Super easy. Great king-size suite. We're in beautiful Sedona. It's in the morning. The weather's wonderful. It's not cold. Just a little jacket weather. And we're gonna walk up to this called Bell Rock. It's beautiful out here. We're on the Bell Rock path near Sedona. Just gonna hike this trail and take some pictures and enjoy the morning. The town of Sedona, it's beautiful. We've just had a hike. And now we've decided we're gonna hit the south rim of the Grand Canyon. That's about 2 hours from here. We're gonna head up to Flagstaff, find something for breakfast, and then head on over to the South Rim. Oh, I'm so excited. We found more of an authentic place to buy jewelry rather than all the shops. Just get driving out of Sedona. Well, we're coming up out of Sedona, headed towards Flagstaff, and we found some snow. At least the weather's still nice, but it's a little chillier. So we're
we're headed north, and we've dropped out of the Ponderosas, and we're dropping down into the desert. We're about 30 miles from the south rim of the Grand Canyon. Well, there's quite a line here to get into the park. Guess we'll wait our turn. Those cute Jeeps. Thank you for a tour. We saw those in Sedona too. Well, the east entrance is closed, and that's Highway 64 that would go to Cameron. That would save us about 100 or more miles of travel, but they say it's closed, so. We'll backtrack towards Flagstaff and then up again. We're headed to Yavapai Point, and we're gonna park and then walk a trail that's right over here. The Grand Canyon is right there, but you cannot see it in this video. Park where we're told face masks required, so we'll get those on and get on the trail. Hiking up the trail. Another little trail to walk down and take a look.
You get your pants yet?
Almost.
More of the Grand Canyon, and there's the river clear down there. It's a huge river, just can hardly tell from here. Headed out on our way to the next stop, which is Kanab, Utah. Got all these people in line ready to go see the Grand Canyon.
Jesus for saving my soul for that bend. With the devil is down alone. It's been some for my.
Well, we thought we'd pull over. We're just a few miles outside of Page, and the sunset was beautiful. We thought we'd stop and watch it go down. There it goes. There it goes. We have done so well until now, and we're back in Utah, and I think we may have been speeding. Here we are in Kanab, Utah, and they're having a balloon festival today, so that kind of worked out great. It's going to be up here against these beautiful red rocks. I don't see any launching yet. But we're also going to make a quick stop at the BLM office and see if we can win tickets to hike the Wave. Gorgeous, beautiful, popular place to hike. It's about 5 miles round trip. Look it up if you haven't seen it. Maybe we'll get lucky and we'll show you. All right, check out this beautiful morning in Kanab. So right there is where the balloons are going to go up. Right here is the BLM office, so we're getting lucky. We're going to be able to kind of do two things here. And this is the first time we've been like out on the road 8 or 9 days. This is the first time we got a continental breakfast. Look how cute this is. There's a muffin, an orange. That was from the La Quinta in Kanab. It was a nice place. Here we are up in the flat. You can hear some of them are starting to get ready. All right, yay, there's one coming up.
we're off to the BLM office at a different location to try to get tickets to the Wave, which is a hike.
Kind of like relief to, like, you know, like kind of like you're
so
like
this is our group. Here, tell us your names. Julian and Adria and Jason. And look at all these people. Lucky 10. So what's the difference between the two draws?
Well, the two draws, you're going to get to do the North Coyote or the South Coyote. And really the difference is you're going to get different views and different destinations. You're going to get, if you do the South, you're going to get to go see Haw Hole, and you're going to get to see Conwood Cave. And from there is just dinosaur prints from, you know, again, I guess what they call a mini wave on the South, and a few other destinations, which you will easily find when you Google it. If you do the North Wave, well, you're really just going to get to go see the Wave, which is about, I think, a 7-8 mile hike to get to. And the views are beautiful on the way. I've never been, but from what I've heard. But of course, the end destination is the classic Wave for the pictures.
And it's 8 miles just to get to it?
They say roughly
three in, three out.
Because
yeah, that's what I read too.
One guy said 11, so I'm not sure the exact route they had planned, the Gaia yesterday, but I did read
you
that
can
I
download
saw.
It on the Gaia.
All right. Here we are. We're getting our application completed, and now we're going to go turn it in over here. Wish us luck, everyone.
It's Tracy getting in her line. Getting ready to turn them in.
Fingers crossed. It's going to be us.
It's going to be us.
I think they're going to land in the parking lot.
Our ticket number is 19, so we are going to sit on row 19.
Well, we didn't win the lottery, so we're at Houston's. Gonna grab some breakfast and pick through some of these other trails. We'll probably go to Buckskin Wash, Buckskin Gulch. Taco omelet at Houston's in Kanab. Highly recommended. Best omelet I've ever had. Here we are, Buckskin Gulch. Here we are and part of Buckskin Gulch. Keeps on winding. Look at this trail. It's like where the cows step the same every time, and it's made it like a little roller coaster. Look how pretty. And we're continuing on. This is the longest one we've been in so far. Wow, this is really cool. I've been on this trail in this Slot Canyon for a good mile. It's very, very cool. I highly recommend it. We're coming out, which this was super awesome. Okay, we're gonna head up a new trail. This is like the beginning of Wire Pass, and it should be only about a mile and a half to the trailhead. So we're gonna go this route and hope for good Samaritans that'll give us a ride.
Look how awesome.
So this is so awesome. It's beautiful. All right, let's see if I can fit through here. It's pretty narrow. Wow. Back in the Slot Canyon. Just keeps going. Well, we found someone to give us a ride, but he only had room for one. So hopefully Jason makes it back pretty quickly. All right, I'm in the truck and I'm very happy. Lesson learned. If you're gonna walk Buckskin Gulch, do not go to the Buckskin Gulch trailhead. Go to the Wire Pass trailhead, and it'll only take about a mile to get down to the Slot Canyons, where we hiked about 4 miles to get to the Slot Canyons, and then 2 or 3 miles until we could, from the trailhead, to get a ride. So, lesson learned. Well, we're headed out of Kanab. We've been gone for 10 days. It's
It's been a great trip. Hiking has probably been the funnest for me, I think, and seeing some new scenery, going to the Grand Canyon. Sedona's gorgeous. Southern Arizona. Going to Tombstone was really fun, and Bisbee's an adorable little town. We stayed in Vegas a little longer than I would do it again, which is really crowded and COVID constraints, and so many things were closed. And anyway, it's been really fun out here. Highly recommend it. Well, home sweet home. It's been a great week, and we're glad to be home and grateful for the moisture.